So the Minneapolis Star and Tribune published an article that our number one fear is speaking in public, and the way to get over that is to imagine yourself in your underwear. And I'm going to do that one better, and I'm actually going to make this presentation in my underwear. So, excuse me. I have two kids. I'm not going to do that. So my job is to create brand names for products and companies. And according to the New York Times, 500,000 new businesses each month launch a million new products. And guess what? They each need a new name. And they go to the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office to a guy named Sheldon. And that's right. That's what he looks like, right? And this is what I'm talking about. So this is Sheldon. And I apologize that that's what you expect him to look like, right? But he can blame his parents because he's probably still living with them. So what's this young lady's name? All right, is it Agnes or Sarabella? Well, clearly. So what's true for human names is true for product and company names. Now, developing brand names is a very creative business, but there is one rule. So professional namers, like myself, get to revoke the creative license of anyone who quotes about this guy, about this flower. And so, we get it. A rose by any other name, blah, blah, blah. It's neither clever nor true. But let me assure you, the flower's name was Schmegrot. It would not smell as wheat or smell as good. So check this out. You're flying around in a spacecraft and you need to stop at a planet for some grass and beef jerky. That's right. It's 3018. You still need fossil fuels. So which planet are you going to go to? Gratak or Naluma? One sounds hard and rough and filled with zombies. The other sounds warm and filled with teeming, attractive millennials who get free juice at their work. So in the news last month, a big American shipping firm, of which there's only one, is buying another firm who ships brown paper packages around the world. This is not 15 seconds, gentlemen. So their name is TNT, all right? So TNT, they ship brown paper packages. So a brand name should embody your brand. So Apple, it's friendly, it's simple, it's everyday, it's good for you, and it's found in every name. IBM, International Business Machines. And my five-year-old loves to say, Daddy, IBM. All right, here's one for you, and now we're caught up. Consider this one, eHarmony, right? eHarmony a name. eHarmony says, I want to find my one and only true love and spend the rest of my life in perfect harmony eating picnics and listening to NPR amidst a grove of elms along the shores of Lake Wobegon. Tinder, on the other hand, says, you're hot, I'm feeling hot, let's have sex right now. So some names are edgy, some names push the boundaries. Adidas has a golf club called Rocket Balls, all right? Some big firm. So it's a great idea, but they're going to have a problem selling this to guys like this at the Edina Country Club wearing green pants who say, Caddy, hand me my Rocket Balls. And this is our favorite, right? All namers love this one. Virgin, great brand, but as a name, do you really want to fly on an airplane who has never flown before? All right, so we even have names for the names we create, okay? So if we vented out a whole cloth, it's called a neologism, like Swiffer and Zynga. They just completely made that up. Others are more descriptive. There's no confusing UPS Next Day Air or Apple, and we love this, Apple Watch. Okay, if you're Apple, you can name anything you want at any time. So if a name is created out of two words or root words, like Medtronic here in Minneapolis, it's called a portmanteau, right? So, and that's from the French word for a suitcase, get it, two halves, portmanteau. So professional namers, like ourselves, we love the portmanteau and we create a lot of names. So we have Flonase, get it, right? I got a nasal problem, it flows. Then there's the other one that we really love called Anusol. All right, so Anusol solves problems with your anu. And if you don't know what an anu is, we hire graphic designers to make it clearer. And sometimes we make mistakes and we get and you flow. Thank you very much, everybody. Bye-bye.